Welcome back to Let's Play. Let's interactively play Steve Jackson's Sorcery. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and this is an interactive Let's Play where you get to choose at the end of the episode what between the choices that are to be made going forward into the next. Now, we're in a bit of a quandary because we're trying to reach this tower. Cannot find a way through because these crazed goblin... Yeah, I wonder if we can get from this way then. Through here. Yeah, if I die again, I'm going to try to go this way. Into this one. Apparently I might be able to go into this one from here. Take the bridge across. Bridge across. Maybe there. Yeah. We've got a bunch. I think we've explored everything on this side. I'm not sure about this one, but I'm pretty sure all of these... So, we shall see. Yeah, so we heroically rushed into the middle of the room, bowling over goblins left and right. But all they succeed in doing is attracting the attention of all the creatures. Their mutual trust is immediate and silent. They begin to surround you. The goblins begin to creep forwards towards you, jaws slavering. Now, attacking is not a good option, I don't think. Could always give it a shot, but I don't think it's a good option. Back away. I'm not sure where we're backing away to. We're surrounded. So the options were to, well, I wrote them down. The dud spell, which is illusion of treasure. The gak spell, G-A-K, which is cause fear. The god spell, which is illusion of worship. And the yob, Y-O-B spell, which is summon a giant. Surprised no one chose summon a giant. Two people chose cause fear, and one person chose illusion of worship. So, if cause fear doesn't work and we have an opportunity to do illusion of worship, we'll do that. But as for now, let's see if fear will even work on these things. They're crazed. They've, like, been starving all this time or something. I don't know. They're insane. Cause fear. Gak. At least it doesn't cause any stamina to cast us. Reaching up to the constellations above, you create the spell, pulling the black face mask out of your pack and putting it on your face. Even in their madness, the contained goblins shrink away in terror, clawing over each other to get away from you. With the crazed mob cowed by your spellcasting, you have a moment to act. That's the problem. We couldn't get through that door, right? Go for the far door. You take advantage of the lull to race across the room. The door to the east is closed and the door in the west wall is open. Okay. Well, I guess we're running east. You try the door. It is locked. Your spell will not last much longer. If you cannot escape, you will be trapped in here with these creatures. Let's retreat. You change your mind and give up on the forward door, racing for the entrance you came in by. Yeah, I... Evidently, we need a key. Charging it didn't work. I think we charged the door. Or we charged this door. I don't even know. For whatever reason, we can't use our open locks and doors spell. So, we're retreating, I guess. You are back on the walkway between the two towers. Darkness closes in. You should find a suitable spot for sleep, especially on an empty stomach. From the tower behind you, you hear a sudden gibbering cry. A horde of ravenous goblins pour from the now open door and scatter in all directions. You have not seen a horde like it since the gates of Kare. They're scattering in all directions. Well, they came out of here, then. How can they scatter in all directions? They can only go forward, which is toward me. Not completely sure. Are they jumping off? Plus, it acts like I haven't been there already. Let's watch them, I guess. You stand back and watch as some hurl themselves off the walkway into the water while others scale the tower. None pay any attention to you. That's good. A few minutes later, the hue and cry is over, and they have all gone, disappearing into the distance across the college. With luck, you will not meet any of them again. I agree. But the south tower door is closed, and no amount of kicking and banging makes it open. There is no choice but to turn back. The south tower door. Where I came from? Or, wait. The bricked-up door hangs open, now all but broken off its hinges. Inside the tower, only corpses remain. The door to the east is closed, and the door in the west wall is open. Okay, so we got a south tower door. I guess this... The south tower door, I'm supposing, is this? And I'm guessing the door to the east is this. Meanwhile, the door in the west wall, the one we just ran out of. Search the goblin corpses. You rifle a few of the goblin carcasses, but to no avail. These must have been sorry creatures. Normal goblins would rather die without a few gold pieces in their pocket. These ones do not even have teeth in their mouths, perhaps as a result of whatever magic conjured them here. Search the room. Maybe I'll find a key. You search the corners of the room, finding clumps of hair and scraps of bones, the remains of the endless cycle of goblins that have occupied this space. But there are still no teeth. We're specifically looking for goblin teeth. I forgot about that. Then, at the bottom of a mess of hair and rags, you find something silver. The key? Nice. Gingerly, you reach into the wreckage of bodies and pull upwards a long silver chain from which hangs a small silver key. You try the silver key in the lock of the eastern door. It turns. You cannot help but laugh at the irony. The key was here all this time, but they were too busy eating each other to notice. There's nothing here but death. You cannot leave fast enough. I agree again. Going to the eastern door. Although we're heading west, or looks like we're heading northwest. You make your way along the walkway between two towers. The moon climbs the sky, filling the world with thin silver light. All around you sense the powerful aura of starlight, washing through this place like icy seawater, and the tower at your back is no more reassuring. Well, thanks for the votes, guys. I think either one would have worked, actually, but... One can only say, I had to cast a spell and then retreat. Who would have guessed? And then they'd run out. But instead, I'm standing on the walkway. And they go every way but the easiest way possible. Okay, look over the edge. Looking down, you see other paths snaking between towers below, but the drop is not inconsiderable. I'm not going to jump off. You back away from the railings and consider the towers ahead. Try the north door or the south door? We just took in, what, east door? Maybe that's the north door. I'm going to take the north door, thinking it might go to that tower. You approach the tower door. It is well preserved and quite intact. You inspect the door, but find no hidden latches or secrets. Unlike most of the doors you have seen in the college so far, this one is in good condition, with few splinters or nicks. A thick layer of dust clings to it. There is the remains of a sign on the wall next to the door, but the only word you can make out is only. The other words have been gouged away with a knife point. Huh. I wonder if there are words before and after only. Sleep here? The short hallway makes for a quiet place to rest, reasonably secluded. Setting down your pack, you try to stretch out despite the wind. You have eaten nothing today, but your pack is empty and you cannot eat. I'm wondering when we'll ever find some food. You get comfortable and rest. What is left of the night is restless with vivid dreams, and all the while you hear distant laughter from the east. The walkway. During the past day, you found no new clues. The Archmage is still waiting for you. Hooray. You get to your feet, shivering slightly in the morning chill. leave the door alone? You turn away from the door once more and head away from the tower. Looking back at the northern tower, you notice someone has fixed a series of metal rungs to the wall, just to one side of the entrance. You tug sharply on the lowest rung. It seems well affixed to the wall. Why not? The rungs are no doubt added to allow people past the north tower without having to find a way through. You quickly begin to scramble up to the roof of the tower. Well, I would like to get in. Maybe we can get in from the other side, the other door on this side. You cling to the tower top, determined not to let the wind rip you free. You look across the towers of the inner college. That's what they call it. They are all different. In subtle and strange ways, they all seem to crackle with energy. Their layout seems both haphazard and deliberate. It is as though you are reading a map of a country you have often walked, but never seen from above. Looking up at the sorcerer's spike from here, it climbs thick and tall into the rumbling skies, a watchman over the centuries that fill this courtyard. There's a sense of the ancient over everything here. Looking down on the other side of the tower, there are no further rungs. You have to slither and drop down as best you can. Let's not drop down just yet. Let's back down and see if I can cast a spell on that door. You climb back down onto the walkway once more. You make your way across the stone walkway, arching high in the air above the swirling waters that pool below, until you return to the curious tower. The early morning sun makes the air glow. The door is now unlocked and hangs wide open. Inside the tower, only corpses remain. Oh, I'm back over here. Both doors are open. There is no reason to stay in this foul place. You cross quickly through. So I have to walk back here to go back there. You are back on the walkway between the two towers. A few clouds drift across the sky, but the south tower... What? Oh, that door is... Yeah, no matter... Blah, blah, blah. It will take years for the smell in this room to clear. Let's go back here. Try a spell on that door. With the way ahead blocked, it seems as though the only way is back. The rungs you noticed earlier climb the northern tower to one side of its entrance. You look one way... and then another along the walkway. You approach the tower door. Nothing about the entranceway has changed. You press your ear to the door, but hear nothing. Oh. I thought we couldn't open it. You grasp the cool handle and push open the door. Nothing jumps out. You step through the doorway. Only to find yourself back outside. The door closed once more. What? You kick the door with all your might. The thud echoes in the small hallway, and the door flies open once more. You step through the doorway a second time, but once again are suddenly faced with the closed door. What is going on here? You lie on your stomach, receiving a thorough coating of dust. Peering through the gap in the door, you spy the legs of a chair, what appears to be a small table placed next to it. You see nothing else, no feet or other furniture. The room appears quite small. Attack the door with my sword. I'm afraid of dulling the sword. Let's try a spell. In the past, when we've attacked inanimate objects, such as even vines with our sword, dulled my sword. Took away some pluses. I don't really like that. So what is at work here? Teleportation? And we should counter it somehow? Oh my god. Will you stop? Okay, resurrection. I don't think it has anything to do with that. Talk all languages. Nope. Let's see the future. Why not? You sit cross-legged on the ground and put your palms on the orb. You spin the constellations into shape around you, and everything changes. You see a small, bare room. There's a table and a chair. Right? Same as it actually is. A woman sits in a chair, carefully marking a piece of slate. She then grabs a nearby hourglass and turns it. She raises her arms and seems to chant. Looking over, she notices the hourglass still running and appears despondent. She marks the slate again as the vision fades. Okay, she's trying to stop time or something like that? Or speed up or reverse time. Let's look at our spells again. I definitely do feel like that is a clue. Cause depression? No. This is gonna be safe passage. Yeah, I'd rather save the stamina. Sense danger, rather. Open locks and doors. Could try that. I mean, that's the obvious answer, but I don't think the obvious answer works in this case. Okay, well, teleportation counters gum. So if we can cast gum... I don't have G. No gum. So maybe it's not teleportation after all. I think I looked at this here for... See the future, yeah. Find safe passage. Could give us a clue, I'd rather just figure it out. Okay, we looked at R. Is that really it? What is Zen? I don't have Zen. Zap counters. This counters Zen. Zen is hovering. Or floating, either one. Trying to look at the counters here. Safe passage is nothing. Talking all languages. I'm really not sure at this point. Let's try this, I guess. Open locks and doors. You cast a spell and hear the latch unlock, then the door swings open by itself. We have another opportunity to cast a spell, though. If I entered, the same thing might happen. Well, we have a different list of spells now. Looks like it might be the same stuff. Let's try this. Maybe there's somebody inside. I don't know. Nope. Removing the green wig, you pull it onto your head and complete the spell, but it seems there is no one about to talk to, so that spell has no effect besides beyond the wig warming your skull. At least we didn't use stamina to waste that. Or waste stamina to do that. Sense danger. What can let me pass? This is only that, yeah. Does it even say what that... It counters far. And far is seeing the future. Interesting how open locks and doors would counter seeing the future. Do I want to cast that again? Now that the door is open? I don't know. I'm tempted, but we really don't have much stamina. Let's just try to get in there, I guess. We reappear outside once more. Whatever is inside this tower, it is extremely well guarded. You slash at the door with some frustration, gouging out chunks from the wood. I didn't hurt my sword, did I? Didn't say I did. Cutlass plus six? I think it was plus six. Damn, you know? Alright, yeah, let's climb the rungs then, I guess. You turn away from the door in some irritation and head away from the tower. Okay, we're scrambling up to the roof. Gonna drop down and see if we can get in the other side, maybe. Probably gonna hurt me. You slither down the slope of the tower, landing on the walkway beyond. Okay, no stamina lost. Another walkway leading between two doors. The south door is closed while the north one hangs ajar. Looking up, you can just make out the perch from the top of the turret, but there's no way up from here. There's no way up from here? Aren't we on a walkway between two doors? I'm confused. You can make out the perch at the top of the turret. Oh, I guess there is no door on the side. The north one hangs ajar, so this one's... Wait. Oh, wait. What did I look at? I thought I looked at the door. You approach the tower door. The door on this side is exactly the same as the door on the other, except there is no sign. You turn the handle again and the door swings open. You step through the doorway and reappear outside once more. Let's see if we have any other spells. Different spells. I'm really trying to get in here, guys. Looks like we have all the same stuff. Zap and zip. Resurrection. I meant to click that. I'm trying to click the F. We got far. Let's try to see the future from here. Same. Alright, let's leave the door alone then. You turn away from the door in some irritation and head away from the tower. You continue along the walkway towards the next tower. Alright, maybe something in here will give us a clue on how to get in there. You hurry over another walkway, higher in the air than you had expected, towards the next tower. The middle of the day is unforgivingly hot. The tower contains a large circular room. A few steps in, however, and you begin to lose your bearings. Oh, brother. Though the tower itself is a simple, clear space, there is something disorientating about it. Perhaps it is because there are so many doors, between 20 and 30 at a rough guess. Worryingly, in the middle of the floor lies a skeleton. You look over the skeleton. It seems perfectly intact, curled up as though asleep. There is no signs of injury, and no shattered bones or twisted limbs. Fragments of cloth remain here and there. Looking more closely at the fragments, you can see they are not the robes of a sorcerer or merchant, but the rags of a peasant, some local of Manpang, perhaps? Under one flap of cloth, you find a simple bronze ring that has fallen from a finger joint. Nice. You pick up the ring and slip it into your pocket. It is of no use for magic and will not be worth anything, but yet it may be useful somewhere. Interesting. Alright, not useful for magic, so it's a regular item then. Uh, Treasure? Bronze ring. Okay. So it's not worth anything, yet it is under treasure. Look at the doors. You turn your attention to the doors. What? Set at regular spaces around this place, or there are about 60 or 70 of them. Between 20 and 30 at a rough guess, now 60 or 70. You can no longer tell which door is the one you came in from. You try to count the doors. After reaching 105, you stop. You must have begun double counting without realizing. There's no way the tower is big enough to hold so many doors. Talk about double vision. We have, like, deca-vision or whatever. Do we dare open a random door? You go over to a door at random and pull it open, but the towers and courtyards have vanished. You find yourself looking out across a deep, deep drop, the wind tugging at your cloak. Far below, birds circle at the base of a crevasse, and what looks like a lynch bug is at work, building a nest of spit and stone. You step quickly back, and immediately lose track of which door that one was. Wow. You pick another door and pull it open. You find yourself on the path through the northern passage of Annaland. The Sightmasters are gathered around, discussing something in hushed, low voices. The group are arguing over what they should do to defend the wall. It seems as though they have no superior officer and no one is in charge. You cannot help noticing how empty the settlement is, as though everyone has retreated. This is no illusion and no trick. You are looking out through the door of the hut of the chief mage on a northern passage of Annaland. Approach them? You step forward, then pause. What if, stepping out of this door, you cannot step back? Yeah, let's close the door. I don't want to make my way through this whole place again. If this truly is a door to Annaland, you cannot afford to step through it. You move back before you lose the way to return, and the door is lost amongst the others. You pick another door and pull it open. You find yourself in the bottom of a deep, rocky cavern. The chamber writhes with hissing, snapping snakes. They are feasting on the corpse of some creature. Shaggy fur covers the floor in tufts, and a scorpion sting is discarded to one side. You lean away before you lose the way to return, and lose track of which door is which. How many should I open? You pick another door and pull it open. You find yourself in a dark crypt. A creature of white light drifts around in small circles as though moving on the extent of its chain. You hurry back before you lose the way to return, lose track, blah, blah. You pick another door and pull it open. You find yourself stepping out from an iron door which slams shut behind you. It takes a moment to realize where you are, the base of the sorcerer's spike. I don't want to go there yet. I have more to explore. Can we go back? Turret door? The sun is beginning to lower and the air begins to cool. This is the east side of a wide courtyard that sits below the sorcerer's spike of Mampang. Guards mill this way and that. A short distance away, a wide set of steps leads up to the tower doors. An iron door leads south out of the courtyard, and a door leads away into a nearby turret. You crane your neck to look up at the sorcerer's spike. The very top is hidden from sight by the lower floors, which jut out and seem older and in worse repair. Despite the impressive doors at the top of the steps, no one goes in or out. These are the Throben doors themselves, no doubt. This place seems as closed off and remote as an island. Looking at the steps from here, they seem wide enough to ride an Oliphant up to the Archmage's doorstep. The door is marked with a small brass plaque. This is the office of the commander of the guard. You can see lantern light flicking through the grimy windows. Open the iron door. You can move. The steps to the Sorcerer's Spike are right in front of you. There is nothing stopping you climbing them and then taking a look at the Throben doors for yourself. I feel like heading to the commander's office. What if we can step back through? I doubt it, though. You knock on the door of the commander's office and a guard opens it. Yes? I have come to see the commander. Prove it, the guard replies. I have important information. The guard sighs. We don't get many troublemakers in this part of Mampang, he remarks. It'll make a change. He whistles, and a few other guards come running. Oh, brother, they grab you roughly by the arms, which seems unnecessary since all they do is take you inside. The room is windowless, but lit by half a dozen lamps scattered about. Khartoum, commander of the guards of Mampang, sits behind a wooden desk covering scattered parchments. Damn, I didn't want to leave. I figured we'd always have a choice whether to go through or not. But for some reason, that fourth try, I think it was the fourth, we just went through. His office is well organized, without the usual detritus and debris you've come to express from the rest of the citadel. The only personal touch is the portrait of a beautiful woman above him. You don't recognize her. You look over Khartoum, somewhat surprised to see that he is human, unlike the orcs and dark elves that make up the bulk of the guards. His square features tell you he is not from Annaland. He might be a renegade from the lands to the east of Kakabad. Who is this? Khartoum demands. His high-pitched voice is an odd contrast to his grim face.
Wait!
He snaps before one of the guards can speak. This is almost certainly the Annalander, wearing a cheap monk's robe. I am not. I am not the Annalander, you insist. Khartoum crushes his arms. I am smarter than you think, wretch. Who do you claim to be, then? I'm on a mission. He leans forward, interested, yet not convinced. A guard begins to speak, but is quieted by a look from her captain. What kind of mission? A mission for the Archmage. Khartoum snorts? What? Snorts, I guess? He snorts. Oh, yes? Tell me then. What is his password? Oh, crap. There is no password. Of course there is. You simply don't know what it is, he replies. What a pathetic lie. There are quite a lot of guards here. Cast a spell. Trying to run, I don't think would be good. Seizing and attacking all of them, I don't think would work very well. I can. Control non-intelligent creatures. Well, they are intelligent, at least reasonably so. Don't think that would work. Illusion of worship. This might come down to this again. Alright, let me write this crap down. Let me see if there's enough. Okay, God spell. Jig. It's fireball. I don't want to waste that stamina. Find safe passage? No. Anything else? No. Sharpen blade, we cannot do. Don't have the beeswax for that. Did I look at G? Oh, Godspell, yeah. Summon darkness. Alright. Summon darkness. Cause invisibility, we don't have that ring. Read minds. Is that it? We tried R, I guess? Yeah, I wish there would be a way to, like, better keep track of, you know, not put it in a jumbled mess like this. Yeah, it doesn't look like... I might have hit R up there. Because I keep forgetting. Okay. This... I think telepathy is a good idea. But I'll leave it for you guys to decide. Of course, they're going to be able to tell. They're going to see me put on this skull cap, so that's a negative. Yeah. So. Spells. I don't think attacking all of them would be wise with 8 stamina. I don't think seizing the commander would be that wise either. Trying to run, they'd catch me. I'm pretty sure. So. Like they said, there's a lot of them. So I'm gonna put yeah, again, here on the side, I'm gonna put an annotation. One of four spells. Choose thy poison. We got the God spell, which is illusion of worship. We got Jig, which is uncontrollable dancing. We got Fog, which is summon God, summon God, summon darkness, and we got TEL, which is telepathy, read their minds. So let me know which you would like me to cast. God, Jig, Fog, or Tel, TEL. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Thanks for voting. Eventually, I'm gonna try to get back to those last few towers, but right now we are here, and we should, I guess, if we get out of this, we can head back. I really want to save this for, you know, when we're done with the towers. Haven't been having too much luck with them lately, though. But thanks for voting, guys. Don't forget to leave your votes in the comments below. Greatly appreciated. And yeah, not much else to see, not much else to say. Endure. In enduring, grow strong. See you next week.